एल्कीन केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज। केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एल्कीन। ओके सो इफ आई लुक एट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एल्कीन राइट इफ आई लुक एट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एल्कीन सो वी नो दैट एल्कीन हैज अ डबल बॉन्ड राइट एल्कीन्स कंटेन अ पाई बॉन्ड। एल्कीन्स व्हाट डू दे कंटेन? अ पाई बॉन्ड in which the electrons are loosely bound. Now I'm saying loosely bound in comparison to the single bond, okay, in comparison to the sigma bond that we saw in alkene, now this is a pi bond, which has electrons which are loosely bound, right? Loosely bound electrons. Now if an electron is loosely bound, you got an assignment. Achha, wait a second. Let me just write this and we will discuss that assignment. Okay. You have some doubt in that, Memuna?
No, sir. I was just telling.
Achha, you were just telling. Okay, fine. Alkenes contain pi bond in which the electrons are loosely bound. And then you can write the next point that since the electrons are loosely bound, alkenes are electron rich. Alkenes are electron rich species. Now, if you have electron rich species, then what will happen? It will add to electron poor species. Okay, and hence they show. Alkenes show addition reaction. Alkenes show what? Addition reaction. What was the name of assignment, Memura?
It was preparation of alkene.
आपको तो नहीं हुआ लगता अपडेट फिर से प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एल्कीन्स ना
यस
आई थिंक दिस इज सिग्मा एंड पाई बॉन्ड्स लेट मी सी अदर्स ओके या आई थिंक बाय रिस्ट्रिक्टेड रोटेशन एंड सी व्हाट वाज द सी क्वेश्चन I don't have the actually. Wait a second.
Cis and trans isomerism.
Which will show cis and trans isomerism. Yeah. Okay, fine. Yeah, this can show cis and trans isomerism. What did Mazia? Mazia 17.4 restricted rotation. Minashi. Minashi, you did not do this. You had to count, I think you had to count na sigma and pi bonds, right?
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh. You had problem in that, Minashi? Did you? Or aalas tha bas aapka? Ji? Minashi?
Yes, sir.
Why did you not count this? Were you not able to count the sigma and pi bonds?
Yes, I was just confused.
You were just confused? Can you try once again? I mean, and tell me in the next class, what were you confused about? Okay. Okay, so this is, thank you, Razan, thank you. 17.4, okay, now this is good that you have, okay, fine, now I understand. You were not able to draw the structure? Yes, Minashi?
Yes, sir.
Were you able to draw the structure? 1, 3, 5, 7, oh, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, then you should be able to count the... रजान ये आपको नहीं आया तीसरा वाला
यस रजान गॉट टू टिक द आंसर
अच्छा यू फॉरगॉट टू टिक दैट ये गलती मत कीजिएगा एग्जाम में, है ना पार्वती? अच्छा, यू हैव शोन आल्सो, राइट? सो दिस इज द सिस फॉर्म, राइट, एंड दिस इज द ट्रांस फॉर्म, करेक्ट? यू हैव आल्सो ड्रॉन द स्ट्रक्चर, वेरी गुड. ओके, एनीवन एल्स? Abdul Rahman, did you send the assignment? Yeah, he has also sent the assignment. He has also drawn it. Yeah, correct. किसी और का रह रहा है क्या? Anyone? No, I think. No. Okay. Let us get back to our class notes here. Yeah. Alkenes, what they will show? They will show addition reaction. Okay, they will show addition reaction. Most importantly, they will be showing what? Addition reaction. And there will be some other reaction that we will be seeing, like ozonolysis and some other reactions that we will, that will come later, right? That will come later. Oxidation and ozonolysis, these are two more types of reaction that alkenes will show. Then first of all, right, addition of dihydrogen. Addition of H2, okay, and this is also known as hydrogenation. Hydrogenation of alkenes. Hydrogenation of alkenes. Now the same reactions we have looked in the in alkenes also. Let me show you. In the preparation of alkenes, where was the preparation of alkene? Yeah, see, this type of okay thing. That means the 28th. This is the same reaction here, okay? So what is happening? Preparation of alkenes, how do we prepare? From unsaturated hydrocarbons, we had alkene, hai na? So in the method of preparation of alkene, we also learned about the reaction or the chemical properties of alkene. We had alkene, we added hydrogen over a catalyst, over a metal catalyst, okay? And then we got what? Then we got alkenes. So same thing we will write here, addition of H2 hydrogenation. Okay, so here you will write alkenes add one molecule of H2, one molecule of H2 in the presence of finally divided nickel, palladium or platinum, okay, and form alkenes. So the reaction you can write are let me write it like this. So this is general alkene. I will add H2, and then in the presence of nickel or PD or platinum, what will I get? I will get a alkene. So there will be C single bond C, a hydrogen will be added on both the carbons, and these bond, whatever it is, they will be as it is, no change. For example, you can write some reactions. You will write the product, okay? Can you guys write the product? Yes or no? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, so here you don't worry, you had alkene, you will get alkene, nothing else, as simple as that. Okay, so just convert them into single bond, just convert them into single bond, nothing else. Write this down, complete the reactions, let me know if you're done, then we will move on. Acha, one more thing that I wanted to say is that Today we will I will leave you guys half an hour early. I have to attend a walima. I will leave you guys half an hour early, okay? So let me know if you're done, okay?
So can you just
scroll up? Okay. More? This is fine?
A little. Okay, fine.
Okay. You have not written few things? Yeah.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Done, guys? Okay, Parvati is done. Maimuna is done. Mazia is done. Okay. Mehreen, are you writing? Yes, Mehreen?
No, sir, I'm done.
Achha, you're done. Okay. So, Mehreen, okay, fine. Yusra, you are writing? Yusra, Sayyid Muhammad?
I'm done, sir.
Done, sir.
You're done. Done. Okay, fine. So, good. So, you all wrote the product also, na? For these two reactions, yes or no? You just had to make alkenes, CH3, single bond, CH3. And here you had to make CH3, CH2, CH3. Nothing else, okay? Easy. Right, next. Right, next. Addition of halogens, you know? Right, next, addition of halogens, right? Second reaction is addition of. Halogens. Now in addition of halogens, what will happen? Write with me, halogens react with. Halogens, they react with alkenes in the presence of inert solvent. And what is inert solvent? Example would be CCl4. You can also have CS2. Rather, don't write CS2. Just write CCl4, that will be enough. You'll be learning about inert solvent in the 12th standard. To form vicinal dihalides. Vicinal dihalide. So again, a general reaction, you have an alkene like this. You react this with what? Now in this halogen, you will have mainly Cl2 or Br2, okay? So I'm writing X2, and this is going to give you, these double bonds will be as it is, and X here, and these double bond will be as it is, and X here, okay? So I mean, you can write X below also. Both of these structures are Cl2, no difference. Here X is equal to chlorine or bromine. X is equal to chlorine or bromine. We don't react fluorine and iodine because fluorine is very fast and it is very explosive in nature. If I do reactions of fluorine, and iodine is very slow. So essentially, we see in room temperature reactions of alkene and halogen, in which halogen is chlorine and bromine. Also write one more note. Reaction with Br2 is used for detection of multiple bonds in an organic structure. In an organic structure. How? Because if you have something like this, C, double bond C, okay, and there is Br2, okay, and there is Br2. Now this Br2 is brown in color. This is brown in color. Brown in color. Okay, and after the addition of Br to the double bond, this becomes colorless. Okay, but I have written here what I have written, multiple bond. Okay, that means the same type of reaction can also happen with alkynes also. You can also have C triple bond C. Something will be here, something will be here. And if you add Br2, same type of reaction will happen. And then you will get C double bond C. There will be some bonds like this, a Br here and a Br here. Okay. Yes. This is also brown in color. This is colorless. So bromine water, Br2, that means bromine water means liquid bromine can be used for the detection of multiple bonds in organic structure. Okay. Write this down, then we will do addition of hydrogen halide. Write this down, raise your hand, then we will do addition of hydrogen halide. So we saw hydrogenation, then we saw halogenation. Now we will see hydrohalogenation. Okay, halogenation, hydrogenation, and now we will see hydrohalogenation. Right, next. Third one. Addition of hydrogen halides, or you can also say halogen acid, or you can also say hydrohalogenation of alkenes. Now, write a reaction here. Write a note. Alkenes react with hydrogen halide. Alkenes react with hydrogen halide to form alkyne halides. Now, what type of reaction will happen? You will have carbon with the double bond carbon like this. There will be some groups attached here. And we will add what? Hydrogen halide, hydrochloric acid, okay? Or you can also have hydrogen fluoride or something else, HX. Now, here X can be, again, we are not using fluorine because it is very reactive. We will start with chlorine, bromine, and iodine, okay? So these are the X. What will happen? One of the carbon, it will take up the hydrogen. The other carbon will take up the halogen. And then you will get what? Alkyne halide. This is alkene. And this is alkyne halide. This is alkyne halide. Write this down. Then we will look at the two parts. We can also, okay. Write this down. Then we will talk about something else. Okay, I think most of you are done. Okay, I'm showing you two alkenes. Okay, I'm showing you two alkenes. Okay. Razan, these alkenes are different, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
These alkenes are different, but both of them have four carbon atoms, correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Now we will classify this type of alkenes. We will classify alkenes into two types. I will say there are some alkenes which are unsymmetrical, and there are some alkenes which are symmetrical. Right? So this is unsymmetrical. Can you see that? And this is symmetrical. Can you see that, all of you? Huh, guys? Meenakshi, yes, Parvati, Raza?
Yes, sir.
Maimuna? Yes, sir. Okay. Now we will see the addition first of all, we'll see the addition in symmetrical alkene. Then we will see the addition on the unsymmetrical alkene. Okay. Unsymmetrical alkene. So let us first do what? Now, before going to the addition of alkene to symmetrical and unsymmetrical, we try to draw a general mechanism. Okay, we will try to draw a general mechanism. So write mechanism. And again, in mechanism, we will keep things simple. We will say that there is only C double bond C. Okay, I will not add any group. I will not attach any group to the C double bond C. We'll keep the C double bond C as it is, like the C double bond C. Okay, is there any problem? You can imagine that there are some bonds here like this. Yes or no, guys? Can all of you imagine like this?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So just forgive me. Now I have written the double bonds and also the other two bonds. Sometime what I will do, I will just write the C double bond C. Okay. So please don't say that sattu galat bana rahe structure type, that kind of thing. Okay. We are now just understanding what is the mechanism. Don't write the mechanism as of now. Don't write the mechanism as of now. So we will have some things which are alkene in the system, in the beaker or in some petri dish, we will have some alkene. And what we have H plus, right? And let me take Br negative, right? And we have alkene. Now what do you think, what is okay, sorry, my mic got muted, I don't know how. Yeah, we have these two things, right? We have these two things in the beaker. Agreed? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. Which of them is more reactive? What do you think? This is more reactive or this is more reactive?
HCl.
HCl. All of you agree, right? HCl. Now, HCl is more reactive. So what will happen to HCl? HCl will convert itself to H plus and Cl negative, right? H plus and Cl negative, correct? Yes or
yes.
No?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now let us move on and let us write H plus and Cl negative. Right? H plus. And we'll write Cl negative. Now you tell me, if I look at the charges, okay? Now there are two ways in which I can say about which is more reactive now. Whether the H plus is going to do something, whether the H plus is going to start the reaction or the Cl negative is going to start the reaction, because both of them are charged species and our alkene, it is simple and it is not a charged species, okay? So it is what, relatively very stable than H plus and Cl negative. So obviously alkene will not be doing anything. He will be just sitting like that, okay? So one of these species, either the H plus or the chlorine negative, it is going to do something to the alkene. It is going to do something to the alkene, okay? Now, what do you guys think? Which is more reactive if I compare H positive and Cl negative? If I look at the charges, both are having the same magnitude of charge, even though the sign is different. That is another thing, the charge, the sign is different. One is positively charged, the other is negatively charged, but the magnitude is same. Okay. Magnitude is same. Now, how will you compare the reactivity between these two? Which will be more reactive, H plus or Cl negative? You may have the answer, but think about the reason. My guess is you all know the right answer. You will be saying the right answer, but think about the reason. Think about the reason. Tell me. Okay, fine. Without the reason, tell me which will be more reactive. Khalil, what do you think? H positive or Cl negative, Khalil? H positive or Cl negative? Okay, don't know. Abdul Rahman? अरे सी समथिंग ना यस और नो आई डोंट नो अब्दुल रहमान ओके एनीवन एल्स मैमूना व्हाट डू यू थिंक व्हिच विल बी मोर रिएक्टिव
सर आई थिंक इट्स H+
विल बी मोर रिएक्टिव अच्छा कैन यू थिंक ऑफ एनी रीजन व्हाई H+ ओके नो प्रॉब्लम महरीन व्हाट डू यू थिंक माजिया मैमून माजिया या Mazia, Mehreen, Minashi, what do you guys think? H plus or CL negative?
CL negative.
Okay. CL negative. Okay, any reason why CL negative?
Because it's more electronegative.
No, okay, fine. Because it is more, what did you say?
Electronegative.
Electronegative. So why it is more reactive if it is more electronegative?
Yes, Parvati. Greater the negativity, greater the reactivity.
Can you explain a bit more? What is reactivity? Reactivity means it wants to attach to something, right? It wants to attach to something. Now, when you're talking about chlorine, chlorine is not in a bonded form. So I think we should not talk about electronegativity, na, Parvati?
So they both are neutral atoms, right?
They both are neutral?
Not neutral, like they have both have fully filled electron configuration.
No, hydrogen, it does not have any electron.
Yeah.
Hai na? Hydrogen, yeah. It does not have any electron. Okay. Now, another thing how you should think is that the charges are same. Okay. Whenever you have positive or negative, these electronegativity, you talk about them in the neutral, you know, when you have something which is neutral. Okay, if you have a molecule in that, you will talk about electronegativity to talk about the reactive sites where it can be. So reactive sites are true, but when we don't have a molecule and when we don't have bonds, so electronegativity has the definition of electronegativity has a bond term in it, right? The word bond in it. So when we don't have a bond, we will not talk about electronegativity. First thing is that. Next thing is that what will determine the reactivity is the charges. Now we compare the charges, both the charges are same. The next thing that we will see is the size of the atom. Now we know that chlorine negative is very large if I compare that to H+. So H+ can be moving very fastly here and there, right? It will be moving very fastly here and there. And what it can do, another thing is that this is what alkene is, electron rich, yes or no? Alkene is electron rich, yes or no, guys? All right, we wrote it, right? It is the electron source, electron rich, alkenes. See?
Yes, sir.
Anna? So what it will do, it will seek something. It will try to find something which is electron deficient. This is electron deficient, right? It's electron deficient. And our alkene here, it is what? It is electron rich. It is electron rich. What happened to my marker? I need a marker. Highlighter, sorry. Yeah. So this is what? This is where the electrons are. Now what will happen? Whenever you are showing some flow of electrons, you will show that with a curved arrow, right? You show that with a curved arrow. Curved arrow starts from electron rich source to electron poor source. Now what you will see? You will see that what will happen? Now this bond is going to break and one of the carbon atoms, it will get the hydrogen. One of the carbon atom, it will get the hydrogen, okay? It will get the hydrogen. So I'm writing H here. I'm not writing anything here. Now, what happened to this second carbon atom here? The second carbon atom, which did not get the hydrogen, it lost one electron. It lost one electron. And that is why it will be a positive charge. It will have a positive charge. Now, we see in the mechanism that there's a carbocation which is formed. The carbocation forms. Okay. So, this is the only part that I wanted to tell you guys, that a carbocation gets formed. Now, don't write this, any of this. And write now, addition to symmetrical alkenes. Addition to symmetrical alkenes. Now, what will happen in symmetrical alkene? We will take an example. We will take an example where we have CH2 double bond, CH2 plus we have Br2. And we are going to react it. Okay, no, not Br2. We have HBr. Sorry for that. We have HBr. Now we know what happens, right? Now we know what happens. Let me draw this thing as a bond like this. HBr. Now this double bond will attack to the hydrogen atom. This Br negative will get the electron from here, and one of the carbon atom will get the, so you will have CH3, and here we'll be having CH2 positive, and there will be Br negative somewhere here, right? Br negative. Now Br negative is electron source. What it will do? It will attack on the carbon atom, and then what it will form? And then it is going to form CH3, CH2, Br, right? So when you have symmetrical alkene, it doesn't matter where the, it doesn't matter the hydrogen atom. Now let us see what will happen if the hydrogen atom went to a different carbon atom, right? So let us see, if you had hydrogen atom, it goes to a different carbon atom like this. You had CH2 positive and CH3, right? So in the first case, this is the first and this is the second. Now in the first case, what happened? The hydrogen went to the first carbon atom, and in the second case, the hydrogen is going to the second carbon atom, and still there is Br negative. Now this Br negative is going to attack to the CH2, and then what is going, what you are going to get? You are going to get a Br, CH2, and CH3. Now if I write this name here, write the name, what will be the name? This will be bromo ethane. This is also bromo ethane. Now as we can see, if I am adding a hydrogen halide to a symmetrical alkene, it doesn't matter the hydrogen is, either the hydrogen is going to the first carbon or the second carbon, we are getting the same product, right? We are getting the same product. Okay, we are getting the same product. We are getting the same product. So you can write this down. Addition to symmetrical alkene. There is no preferential addition, right? That means hydrogen is not getting attached to a particular carbon atom. It can get attached to any carbon atom. Done, guys? Let me know if you're done. Hello, raise your hand if you're done, guys. Okay, fine. See, all of you are done, okay, fine. I'll write some examples. So what will happen? You will get, here you can write hydrogen and here you can write bromine, okay? Or you can also write both are same things, right? There will be no change in the name. You can write hydrogen here and you can write the bromine here. It doesn't matter. Moreover, there can be more symmetrical alkenes. For example, if you can have a cyclohexane and you have a double bond here, okay? You have a double bond here. So you have 1, 2 carbon atoms, 3 carbon. So this whole structure is what? It is symmetrical, right? You can see it is having some kind of symmetry. We'll add, let us add HBr, and what you are going to see, that it doesn't matter whether the bromine is getting added here and the hydrogen is getting added here, or it is the other way around. It is the other way, right? Other way around, you have hydrogen here and the bromine here. Okay. All these structures are same. Suppose you have 6 carbon atoms, here also you can form 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, and there will be Br here, there can be hydrogen here, right? So there is practically no difference where the hydrogen atom is getting attached first. Write the reactions down, let me know if you're done, then we will move to unsymmetrical alkenes. Okay, seems you guys are done. Razan and Minashi are done.
No, sir, I'm not.
Okay, Maimuna, right. When do you guys have your examination? February mid or February end? Mid of Feb or end of Feb?
February second week.
Second week, mid of Feb. Okay. हो गया मैम ना आपका?
Yes sir.
Okay. What happened to Khalil? Khalil, are you there? कुछ बोल ही नहीं रहे आज आप?
Yes sir, I'm there.
अच्छा, you're there. आ रहा है ना आपको? जी?
Yes sir.
Okay. Right. Addition to unsymmetrical alkene. Addition to. Unsymmetrical alkene. Now, in addition to unsymmetrical alkene, we will take an example that is of propene. Okay, propene is a good example. So we have CH3 CH double bond. CH2. Now, if I add HBr here, okay, I am adding HBr here. What is going to happen? Let us say we'll write plus HBr. Then again, this double bond is going to attack to this hydrogen. Now, here we have two different types of carbon atom. We have one carbon atom here like this. Let us say this is the second carbon atom like this. Okay. Now, let me first of all tell you what is going to happen if I have the first case. What am I going to get? What I'm going to get is CH3, a single bond, CH2, a single bond, CH2, positive. I'm going to get this. Now, if I add the hydrogen to the second carbon atom, which I have labeled as second carbon atom, then I'm going to get CH3, single bond, CH with a positive charge, and then here I will get CH3, right? I will get CH3. Now we have got two types of carbocation. Both of these are carbocation. Now, out of these two carbocation, the carbocation which is more stable will be formed more, right? The more stable, the stable carbocation will be formed in large quantity. And faster, right? Because if something is stable, now this alkene, it has only two choices, right? It has, essentially speaking, it has one choice, but more precisely speaking, it has two choices in that one choice. It had one choice to make a carbocation, so it had made carbocation. Now, inside carbocation, it has two choices. Either it can make the first carbocation, this is our first carbocation, and this is our second carbocation. Now, who will tell me which is more stable here? Which is more stable and which will be formed in more in large quantity? Which is more stable, guys? Which is more stable?
So the second one.
How? Why, Parvati? Second one?
So second degree carbon.
Second degree carbon, carbocation, right? When we have second degree carbocation, that means there is more number of hyperconjugating structures that can be made, right? And there is more inductive effect also. So these CH3 groups, they will be giving electrons to the C positive, and what will happen? The second will be more stable, right? Second will be more stable. So I will write this as more stable. This is going to be more stable. Now, if something is more stable, that is going to be formed in a very large quantity, and the equilibrium, it will be shifting towards that carbocation. The equilibrium will be shifting towards that carbocation, and you will have the major Br negative. This Br negative is going to attack here, and then what you're going to form? You're going to form CH3 single bond CH. There will be Br somewhere here, and then you will get CH3. Okay. So this is the mechanism. This is what happens if you have unsymmetrical alkene. So please write this whole thing down. Then we'll write it in words also. Then we will write it in words also. Yusra is done. Who else is done? Please raise your hand. Okay, so most of you are done. Mazia, Mehreen. Mehreen, you are not done, or are you done, Mehreen? Done. Okay. So, right. Okay. What I'm going to say is that we have two parts in the reagent. We have substrate. This is our substrate. The organic part of our reactant is known as the substrate. HBr is the reagent. HBr is the reagent, which is more reactive part. Now, the reagent has two parts. One is what? One is the positive part. That means H plus is the positive part. Br negative is the negative part, right? So H plus, I'm going to say that it is the positive part, and Br negative is the negative part. So what is happening here? I can write a generalized line that the positive part of the reagent, the positive parts of the reagent gets attached to that doubly bonded carbon atom which has less number of hydrogens. Okay, which has less number of hydrogens. You can also write this as more substitution. What does more substitution mean? The carbon attached to more number of carbon atoms. Okay, which has, wait a second. Yahan pe humne ulta likh diya, the positive part which has less number of hydrogen, or no, more number of hydrogen. And this will be less, sorry, or less substitution. Okay, so the positive part of the reagent, that means the hydrogen is getting attached to that carbon atom which has more number of hydrogen atoms, okay? So write this down, let me know if you're done, then we will do some examples, okay? Done?
Yes.
Done. Okay, fine. Write here, example. Okay. Do you know around which carbon atom? There are two carbon atoms here. This is the red carbon atom. This is the black carbon atom. Can you tell me which is having more number of hydrogen and which is having less number of hydrogen? Guys, or should I make the carbon CH3 and that type of stuff?
Great.
Wait a second. Let me reshare this. Yes, Parvati, you are saying
the right one.
Which has more number of hydrogens, Parvati?
Red one.
Red one. Okay. Red one. So what will happen? The hydrogen will get attached here. Okay. And we'll have a positive charge here. The Br negative, it will attach. It will attack here. And then you will be getting. Br and there will be hydrogen here. Okay, Maheen, wait a second. I will go up.
Thank you, sir.
Ho gaya kya aapka? Likh liya aapne?
Yes, sir.
Acha, nahi likhna tha. Okay. Maheen, is there anyone who is not able to understand this type of structure? The bond length structure? Please tell me. Please tell me if there is someone who cannot understand which of the carbon will have less number of hydrogen and more number of hydrogen. Okay, it seems everyone can understand. So I will ask each one of you one by one. Khalil, you will tell me. The hydrogen will attach to black or blue.
Yes, Khalid.
Okay, blue. So what will happen? This will get a positive charge and here you will attach a hydrogen atom. Then the bromine will come and it will attack here, right? The bromine negatives. Bromine. And here you have the hydrogen which is attached. Okay, Maheen, you will tell me, okay, now. Maheen, you will tell me. Tell me one or two. Which carbon atom has more number of hydrogens? Yes, Maheen. Oh, what did I ask? Sorry. Which carbon atom has more number of hydrogens? One or two?
Two.
Two. Okay, fine. So here positive and here you will attach a hydrogen. Then Br negative will come. It will attack here. Okay, and Br negative here like this. And there's a hydrogen here. Now, I think you can, you guys can see one more thing which is happening, that we wrote regarding the positive part. We can also write something regarding the negative part. Okay, so we can write. Negative part of the reagent gets attached to that carbon atom which has less number of hydrogens or more substitution or more substitution. So this line now, this line, see, this is something which is very logical, right? This is something which is very logical, but this is known as the Markovnikov rule. The above rule is known as, this is known as Markovnikov's rule. Okay. Any idea? Can anyone guess what is the country of origin of Markovnikov? He was from which country? By looking at the name, can anyone guess? No one.
Russian.
Yeah, it is very good. It is Russian. Markovnikov is Russian. Markovnikov's rule. Okay. Let me know if you're done. Done, guys? Yes, done or not done? Okay, done. Most of you are done. Okay, fine. Right, next. This is important. Okay, this is very important. Hydrohalogenation. In the presence of peroxide. In the presence of peroxide. Okay, in the presence of peroxide. Now again, we will not write anything. We will start with a peroxide. We have seen what is hydrohalogenation, but let us see what happens if we have a peroxide. If we have a peroxide. So we can take any peroxide. Let us take any peroxide, for example. We should start with a reaction something like this. Okay, unsymmetrical alkene. Still we have unsymmetrical alkene. CH3, single bond, CH with a double bond, CH2, plus we have HBr. But it is happening in the presence of what? R, O, O, R. Okay. What is R, O, O, R? This is peroxide. Okay. Hydrogen peroxide is H, O, O, H. This is organic peroxide. So if you have CH3, O, O, CH3, this is methyl peroxide. For example, you can also have benzoyl peroxide. Okay. You can have many different types of peroxide. We'll not worry about that, but we will write a generalized reaction when we have ROOR, and we will see what is going to happen. What is going to happen? Now, whenever we have a peroxide, I think you should remember that if you have heat, electricity, light, or peroxide, if you have heat, you have electricity, or if you have light, H nu, or if you have peroxide that is here, then you are going to get a free radical. Then you are going to get what? A free radical. So there is will be a chain initiation step, right? The first step will be something like this. We will have R, O, O, R, and it will interact with light. I mean, in sunlight only. If you just keep it in open air, what will happen? Both of these bonds, the OO bond, which is very reactive, it is going to dissociate, and it will form like this. One of the electrons will go here, the other electron will go here like this, and it will be forming R, O free radical plus RO free radical, RO free radical plus RO free radical. Now, the next thing that is going to happen is that second step, we have RO free radical. Okay. Now, please remember that this RO free radical, it is not only having one electron here like this. Let me show the whole thing with oxygen. Now, I hope you guys know that oxygen will have two lone pairs like this. Now, after the homolysis, that means the homolytic fission, you will have RO, there will be 1, 2, 3, 4, and there will be one more electron like this, plus RO, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yeah. So we have this type of structure, and then this one of the free radical, it is going to react with HBr, because the next reactive substance in the system, in our beaker, is the HBr. What will happen now? This oxygen atom, it will take up its one electron, the HBr bond, it will come up with one electron. Okay, the hydrogen is coming up with one electron, and it is going to form R, O, and OH bond will be formed. Now, this one electron will be going to the Br. So we have Br free radical. So what is happening? Let me tell it once again. So we had the free radical of RO. It used its electron, and the hydrogen of HBr, it used one electron from the bond. And both of them made a new bond, that is the OH bond, that is the OH bond. And now the electron, it was only remaining with Br. So we showed that electron like this, this electron. One of the electron from the bond is with hydrogen. It formed a bond with that. One of the electron is with bromine, and it has formed a free radical with that. It has formed a free radical with that. Now we have the bromine part, which is interesting, right? The bromine free radical. Now, then we have the alkene here, and bromine, they will react with each other. So we have bromine free radical plus CH3 with a single bond CH with a double bond CH2 with a double bond CH2. Now, again, I can see that there are two things which can happen. Either the bromine will attack on the first carbon, or it can attack on the second carbon. It can attack on the second carbon. Now, let us see what will happen if it attacks on the first carbon and it makes a bond with the first carbon. obviously this bond is going to break, this bond is going to break, and you will be getting something like this, CH3 with a single bond CH, and the bromine is attacking on this carbon atom, so bromine, and then there will be a single bond, and here we'll be having CH2 free radical. Now in the second case, what will happen? The bromine is going to attack the second carbon. So we have CH3, a single bond CH, a single bond CH2, and there will be a bromine attached here. A bromine attached here. There will be a free radical here. There will be a free radical of the carbon which is in the middle. Now again, we have two intermediates. Both are free radical, and we also know that free radical are what? Free radicals are? Free radicals are electron deficient. Free radicals are electron deficient. That is why I can say that this 2-degree carbon atom, this 2-degree carbon atom will be more stable. This will be more stable, right? More stable. Now, as you can see what is happening now, if this is more stable, then the fourth step, in the last step, what will be happening? You will have CH3, CH free radical, and there will be CH2, Br plus HBr. Now, one electron from the carbon and one electron from the hydrogen, they will react with each other and they will form CH3, CH2, CH2, Br, plus one more Br free radical. Now, this Br free radical is going to attack to one of the alkenes, and the reaction will proceed until it ends, okay, until it ends. So this will be the major product. This will be the major product. Now we can see that this is completely opposed with the major product that we formed if we did not have the peroxide. So you can write here, in the presence of peroxide, in hydrohalogenation of unsymmetrical alkenes, the negative part, of reagent gets attached to that carbon atom which has more number of hydrogen or less substituted carbon atom of the double bond. This above rule, it has many names, okay? So one of the name is, the above rule is called anti-Markovnikov, you know, because it is opposite of Markovnikov. This was given by a scientist who's named as Kharash effect, or it is also known as peroxide effect. Peroxide effect. Okay. Write this down, then we'll do some questions. Let me know if you're done, okay? The important thing that you have to remember is that when you have a peroxide, then what is going to happen? Then the negative part, negative part, it is going to attach to which carbon atom? Which has more hydrogens. Which has more hydrogens. Which has more hydrogens. Okay, I think you guys are done. Is there anyone who is still writing? Is there anyone who is still writing? No. Okay. Now, let me summarize whatever we have learned regarding the addition in unsymmetrical alkenes. We will have R. We have R, which is attached to CH, double bond CH2. And we have HX. Let us write HX. Then there are two ways of this reaction to be happening. Okay, simple reaction. Then what will happen? R, CH, it will attach the X, and then you will have CH3 here. This is what? This is Markovnikov. Markovnikov. Okay, Markovnikov. Or else you can have, if you have peroxide, then you will get R, CH2X. It is anti-Markovnikov. Or harsh. Or peroxide effect. Or peroxide effect. Write one note here. Only HBr shows peroxide effect. That means HCl and HI, they won't show peroxide effect. Okay, HCl and HI, they won't show peroxide effect. Itna likhiye, then we will do some problem. Done, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Write the major product. For following, okay. Okay. Yusra, are you there? No, Yusra is not here. Razan? Yes, Razan?
Yes, sir.
Markovnikov or anti-Markovnikov? First, tell me that in this reaction, A1, Markovnikov or anti-Markovnikov?
Markovnikov.
Why Markovnikov? Abhi to likha hai humne Razan. Aise kaise chalega kaam? If you have peroxide, then it is anti-Markovnikov, na? Okay, Abdul Rahman. Please write this down. Let me know if you are not done, okay? Write this down. Razan, did you write this? Huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, please identify these things. Okay, simple things. Peroxide means anti-Markovnikov. If you don't have peroxide, that means Markovnikov. Okay, then you have to also remember the rules that when you don't have peroxide, then the negative part will attack on the carbon that is more substituted. Negative part will attack on the carbon which is more substituted. Abdul Rahman, let me know if you're done. Yes, Abdul Rahman, let me know if you're done, okay? Okay. Yes, tell me now. Razan, Markovnikov or anti-Markovnikov?
Anti-Markovnikov.
So, the negative part, which is negative part in the HBr? Hydrogen or bromine? Which is negative part? Hydrogen or bromine?
Bromine.
So, bromine will attack. Bromine will attach to more substituted carbon or less substituted carbon. Where will the bromine attack? It will get attached to which carbon atom? One or two? Tell me. Read and tell me, okay, please. Read and tell me. It will attack on two, right?
Yes.
That's it, okay? Now B part.
So you don't put the hydrogen atom.
We don't need to, or do we need to put the hydrogen atom, Parvati?
No need.
So, slowly, for our advance, hota jaiye, na? We need to write less. We need to write less, understand more. Okay. Razan, once again. Tell me, Markovnikov or anti-Markovnikov, Razan?
Anti-Markovnikov.
अरे आप तो पूरा पढ़ती नहीं है यहाँ पे देखिए ओनली एच बी आर शोज परोक्साइड इफेक्ट दैट इज एंटी मार्कोनिकोव इफेक्ट ना यस रजान
यस सर
अरे ऐसे कैसे काम चलेगा आप हाँ हमेशा कुछ ना कुछ भूल जा रही हैं तो यहाँ पे क्या होगा दिस इज मार्कोनिकोव ओके दिस इज मार्कोनिकोव सो व्हाट विल हैपन दी वी हैव टू पार्ट्स हाइड्रोजन एंड क्लोरीन वी हैव वन कार्बन एटम दिस इज द सेकंड कार्बन एटम व्हाट विल हैपन द क्लोरीन विल अटैक ऑन द फर्स्ट कार्बन एटम हियर ओके फॉर अ चेंज chlorine like this okay you can write the chlorine like this okay this is CH3 So write these three examples. Let me know if you're done. Then we will move to a similar reaction. Okay, a similar reaction. Yeah, done guys? Done everyone? Hello. Yeah, okay, fine. I can see people. Please let me know if you are not done, okay? Please let me know if you are not done. Done. Okay, fine. Right, next. That is the addition of water. Next, that is the addition of water. Addition of water, write with me. When alkenes are treated with few drops of concentrated H2SO4, with water, they form they form alcohols. They form alcohols. Okay. Next point. Addition of H2O follows. Markovnikov rule. Okay. So a general reaction will be C double bond C. If you have C double bond C and then you add water to it in the presence of sulfuric acid, that means you will have some acidic condition here. And what you are going to get, you are going to add a hydrogen and then OH. So you are going to add hydrogen like this and a OH group like this. So this is the alcohol. So you're forming alcohol from alkenes, alcohol from alkenes. Now, important thing is that you should remember that this also follows the Markovnikov rule. That means if you have unsymmetrical alkene, if you have unsymmetrical alkene, let us take an example of unsymmetrical alkene. If you have propene, let us say, you have propene like this, plus H2O, in the presence of some acidic condition, that is H plus, what is going to happen? The oxygen, the OH negative, right? Now we have two things here in H2O. We have the H plus and we have the OH negative, right? So what is the positive part and the negative part? The positive part is the H plus again, the negative part is OH negative. So OH negative is getting attached to the carbon, which is more substituted. So it is getting attached here, OH, right? OH is going to get attacked. Next, you can write a few more examples.
Done,
all of you?
Yes.
Right, yes. Next, oxidation. Yusra, you are getting disconnected so often. Is your internet not good? Yes, Yusra. What is happening? There's a disconnect. Yeah. Oxidation of alcohols. Write with me. Alkenes on treatment with cold dilute aqueous solution of potassium permanganate, right? Potassium permanganate, KMnO4. This is also known as the Bayer's reagent, okay? This is also known as Bayer's reagent. Aqueous solution of KMnO4 produce, what do they produce? Ricinyl glycol. Ricinyl glycol. So if you have, let us say, carbon, the double bond, that is alkene, and you add aqueous, that means you will have H2O here, right? You will have H2O here, and then you are doing some oxidation, right? So you have dilute KMnO4. And it is saying that cold, now. So cold, you will take that at 0 degrees Celsius or 273 Kelvin. Okay. If you want more marks, you write 273 Kelvin. Okay, Yusra. No, I mean, you don't need to be sorry. It's fine. I'm just wondering whether you are following me or not. That's my major concern. Okay. then what you are going to get? You are going to get vicinal glycol, right? What is vicinal? That means neighboring. What is neighboring? OL group is neighboring. OL means the hydroxy group, that is the OH group. So you will get something like OH here, and you will get something like OH here, right? This is known as, this is a glycol. When you have two OH groups attached side by side, that is, yeah, if there are two OH groups, then those are known as glycol. If there are two OH groups on adjacent carbon, those are known as vicinal glycol. Those are known as vicinal glycol. You don't need to worry about the Markovnikov or anti-Markovnikov, because both of these groups are the same group, OH and OH. Similarly, you can have, let us write some more examples. Plus H2O, and in the presence of the same things, right? KMnO4 and 273 Kelvin. Then you're going to attack the OH here, attach a OH here, and attach a OH here, right? Like next. Now in the second part, right? Treatment of alkenes. Now we are going to change. Now we are going to change the conditions. Okay. So we have the same potassium, which we have the same potassium permanganate, right? But here we are using treatment of alkenes with hot acidic potassium permanganate. Hot and what? Acidic potassium permanganate. Then it oxidizes alkenes to, it oxidizes alkenes to ketones or carboxylic acid. It will either, if you keep it for a very long time, it will oxidize it to carboxylic acid. Now, if you remove or if you distill the ketone, then you will get only ketone. You will get only ketone. Okay. Now, it also depends on what type of alkene is there. To ketones or carboxylic acid, depending on the nature and experiment nature of alkene and conditions. Okay, so I will write two reactions here. Let us say we have something like this. There's a carbon atom and you have CH3, and this carbon atom has a double bond CH2. It has a double bond CH2. Then what is going to happen here? If you have, let us say you have KMnO4 in the presence of acid, in the presence of H plus, that is acid, then this CH2, it will get away and you will get C double bond O, CH3. Now this carbon, which is CH2, it will form CO2 and this H2 will form H2O. Okay. So this is a case where the nature of alkene is taking precedence and it is forming a ketone. Now, if we have something different, let us say if you have something, for example, but2-ene, okay, but2-ene, and you have the similar conditions, right? KMnO4 in the presence of H plus, then what is going to happen here? You are going to form this bond will break, and you will have C double bond O, and here only you will have the OH group attached. Plus this entity, this part here, we have written about this part. Okay, there is another part which is like this, right? Then this part can be written as so. Now both of these are what? Both of these are ethanoic acid, right? Here we also have two carbon. Here also we have two carbons. Here we have carboxylic acid group. So both of these are what? Ethanoic acid. Okay. Write this down. Let me know if you're done.
then we will move on further.
Done, guys?
Yes.
Okay. Write a note here. Bayer's reagent is pink in color. And is used to detect alkenes. Right? And how? You have alkene like C double bond C. It has some bonds like this. It has some bonds like this. Plus you have the KMnO4, right? The Bayer's reagent KMnO4. This is pink in color. And after reaction, what it is going to form? It is going to form glycol, vicinal glycol, right? And these double bonds will be as it is. This is colorless. Now, if you see a change in color, if you add something to the pink Bayer's reagent and the pink Bayer's reagent, it becomes colorless. That means there was an alkene. Whatever you added, it was an alkene. Okay. Write this down. Let me know if you're done.
Done.
Okay. Now, also one more thing you can write. We have seen that this is on the nature of alkene and the condition, right? And the condition. So let us see what will happen if you have different types of alkene. Okay, if you have different types of alkene. Now you will have a double bond, okay? You will have a double bond, right? There will be some groups attached this side and some groups attached this side. So I'm writing about those groups. You will make it out, okay? And then when we will do examples, that thing will stick in your brain. So let us write on treatment with hot KMnO4 in the presence of H plus, right? In the presence of H plus. Then what happens if you have something like this? If you have a double bond carbon, right? A double bond carbon like this, and it has R group attached to it, R and R group attached, okay? So one of the carbon is what? It is having R and R group attached. So it gets oxidized to ketone. So this will get oxygen here like this. This R groups will be as it is. Now, if you have a carbon, it has a double bond and it is attached with an R group and the other bond is with hydrogen, then it is going to get converted into what? It is going to get converted into carboxylic acid group. So you will have the R group here like this. You will have the C double bond O like this. This hydrogen, there will be an oxygen attached here with the hydrogen like this. Okay. So this is ketone. And if you have if you have something like this, then this is going to be converted into carboxylic acid. And at last you can write, if you have a C double bond O, not a CH2, okay, a CH2, like the terminal carbon, then it is going to get converted into carbon dioxide, CO2, okay? Write this down, then I will ask you some questions and you can answer me. We have only one reaction left, that is ozonolysis, and there is polymerization also, I think. Polymerization, yeah. But I need to go to the Walima. I need to go to that reception. Right, John? Then we will ask questions. Then ozone analysis and polymerization, we will do in the next class. Or rather, what I can do, I can spend 10 minutes here with you guys. And yeah, I think ozone analysis karke hi jaate hain aaj. Done, guys? Yes or no? Hello.
Yes,
okay, fine. Okay, very good. Now let us do some examples. Okay. Yusra, are you there? No, Yusra is not there. Yusra got disconnected. Parvati, okay, Yusra is here, but she is not saying anything. Yes, Parvati?
Yes, sir.
So you tell me this this fragment here, okay? This fragment here that we have taken. So it is resembling which part? 1, 2, or 3? It is resembling the first example, second or the third example? Tell me.
Third example.
Sorry?
Third example.
Acha. Let us try to write it completely, na. So this will be CH3, CH, double bond CH, and CH3. Yes, tell me, Parvati.
It forms a carboxylic acid.
Carboxylic, not the third, na, second one, na. Yes or
yes,
no?
Sir.
So there's one. This is the double bonded carbon atom we are interested in. This is the double bonded carbon atom we are interested in. This carbon atom is attached to an R group, and there is a hydrogen which is not seen. The hydrogen which is not seen. Okay. Now both of these are resembling. Both of these are resembling what? Both of these are resembling the second example where we are getting the carboxylic acid. So this is what you will be getting here. The same ethanoic example, okay? If you have something like this, then what will happen? So this fragment here, we have two fragments here, right? So this is the one fragment, and then you have the other fragment, which is the green one, let us say, right? So this is the first fragment. This is the third fragment. Yes or no?
Yes.
Hai na? All if you can see that. So the first fragment is going to make ketone. Then the second fragment is going to make CO2. It is going to make CO2. Okay. You can write more examples like this. If you have something like this and you have a double bond CH2 group, then what is going to happen? You have this carbon atom and then you have the other carbon atom. Just write it, this carbon atom. So the green one, I don't know. Let me just turn my flux off. Okay. So green and that is purple. Okay, so the green one, it is representing what? The first example, the first type of fragment, and the CH2 is representing what? The third type of fragment again. So you will get a ketone. You'll get a ketone like this, and you will get a carbon dioxide. Okay, you will get a carbon dioxide. Write this down. Let me know if you're done. And we will do ozone analysis later only. Ozone analysis needs some background and all. It will take more than 10 minutes. And then questions also. So later on. Rather, what I should do, I should give you some examples, right? I can give you some homework questions. Okay, so done, guys? Yes or no? Khalil, Maimuna, Mazia?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So rather, right, this is homework. Write the major product. Or following. CH3OCH3. This is a type of peroxide. Write the 6 problems. Let me know if you're done. Then we can close this meeting. Okay. We will meet on Thursday. Is there anyone who is still writing? Razan, Parvati, Minashi, Isra is done. Abdurrahman. Yeah, sure, Abdurrahman. Sure. Is this fine, Abdurrahman? I think this is fine. Done? Okay. All of you done?